Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to talk about optimal binary search tree, solved example for 4 nodes only with formula. There are actually 2 methods to construct the optimal binary search tree. For the detail about optimal binary search tree, you have to visit my previous video, that is Introduction to Optimal Binary Search Tree, as well as the solved example video. For both, I am going to provide here a link, shortcut link for a playlist. You can go through that and then you can resume this video. Now we'll see which are the methods used for the construction of optimal binary search tree. So to construct optimal binary search tree, the first method is logical method, where I'll apply some logic to construct the optimal binary search tree. The logic is more frequency node will be at the higher position or higher level, and the less frequency node will be at the lower level. The higher level is nothing but either root level or a parent level, and the lower level will be a child level or a leaf level. So if the frequency is high, node will be at the higher level. If the frequency is low, node will be at the child or leaf level. The second method is practically by applying a formula. So which formula I need to apply? So I need to find out the cost of I, j, for which I'll require weight of I, j plus cost 1 I, m minus 1 plus cost 2 m, j. What all these values are? For this, j is nothing but the key number from my frequency table. Wt is nothing but weight, associated weight, and the last one, m, is nothing but my current root. For which root I am going to perform the operation? For this, I am going to use the pronunciation or the letter or the symbol m over here. Now let's start with the example. For this example, I have used 4 keys. They are key number 1, 2, 3, 4. For this, the keys are 12, 13, 16 and 28 respectively. And for that, the frequencies are 5, 3, 6 and 2 again respectively. Here you need to keep one thing in mind, that all these keys must be in increasing order. In your frequency table, the keys will be in increasing order. The frequency is nothing but the number of times any particular key is going to be searched. So if I want to search 12, its frequency is 5. To search 13, its frequency is 3. For 16, its frequency is 6. And for 28, the frequency is 2. Now let's start for the solving or the construction of optimal binary search tree with the help of formula. For this, I'll require a matrix. This matrix is called as cost matrix. This table is called as frequency table. This cost matrix is always number of keys plus 1 size cost matrix. That is, now here number of keys are 4. 4 plus 1, the size of cost matrix is 4 plus 1, that is 5 by 5. That is, 5 rows are there and 5 columns are there. Rows are going to represent by I and columns are going to be represented by j. Now we'll apply step 0 for 0 number of nodes. For 0 number of nodes, for this I need to find out n is equal to j minus I is equal to 0. For all the combination of j minus I, if it results into 0, I'll consider that pair to find out the cost of I, j. The first pair is, if my j is 0 and I is also 0, my result is 0, so that's why I'll find out the cost of 0, 0. Now here the number of nodes are 0, that is null tree is there, so that's why cost is also 0. So for this, cost of 0, 0 is 0. Next combination is, for j is equal to 1, I is equal to 1, cost of 1, 1 is again 0, cost of 2, 2 is also 0. Cost of 3, 3 is also 0. Cost of 4, 4 is also 0. So here I am getting these 5 values, where the cost is 0 for all the combination, because for 0 number of nodes the cost is 0. I'll put all these values in my cost matrix, and after putting the values into the cost matrix, these values I am going to represent with the help of pink color. These all diagonal values I am getting now, all these values are 0. This gray part I am not going to consider while construction of optimal binary search tree. Only the upper matrix I am going to consider for the construction of optimal binary search tree. Now let's move to the step number 1. For the step number 1, the previously generated cost matrix I am going to use over here in the previous step, and now the step number 1 I am going to start for a single node. For a single node combination, I will find out again n is equal to j minus i is equal to 1. For all the combination of j minus I is equal to 1, for that I'll find out a cost of I comma j. Now I'll see for which combination I'm getting the result for j minus I is equal to 1. So if j is 1, I is 0, the result is 1. So what I'll do, I'll find out the cost of I comma j is nothing but 0 comma 1. For this, now for a single node, I'll put the frequency as it is, as its cost. Now here j is nothing but the node, key number of a node of which I'll put a frequency. So j is equal to 1, that's why I'll put a frequency 1, that is 5 over here. For the next combination, 2 minus 1 is equal to also 1. For this, I'll find out cost of 1 comma 2. Here j is 2, means I'll use the frequency 2, and frequency 2 is nothing but 3 from my frequency table. For the next, 3 comma 2 is equal to 1, cost of 2 comma 3 is equal to frequency 3 and is nothing but 6. And the last one, last combination, is 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. For this, I'll find out cost of 3 comma 4 is nothing but my frequency 4 is nothing but 2 from my frequency table. I'll put all these values in my cost matrix, and I'll update cost matrix for 0 comma 1, 1 comma 2, 2 comma 3, 3 comma 4 by putting the values 5, 3, 6 and 2 respectively. Again, pink color cells which are updated right now. I'll use this matrix for step number 2. I'll go forward for the step number 2, where the previous matrix is I'm going to use as it is over here for all I and j, the number of columns and number of rows. Here in this step, I'm going to use the combination of two nodes. For the combination of two nodes, what I'll do, I'll find out for n is equal to j minus I is equal to 2. For this, my first j is equal to 2 and I is equal to 0. For this, what I'll do, I'll find out the cost of 0 comma 2. For this, two possibilities are there. Either root is going to become the first key, or the root is going to become a second key. For the two keys, I am going to perform the operation as I said previously for the combination of two nodes or two keys. So which two keys I am going to consider? This j will decide how which two keys. So j is equal to 2, it means that the second key will come always with the key number 1. So that's why 12 and 13. For the key number 12 and 13, I am going to find out the cost. For 12 and 13, either 12 is going to become a root node or 30 is going to become a root node. For this, the formula, I'll apply a formula. Before that, I need to find out a weight. To find out a weight, I have to find out weight 0, 2. For this weight, what I'll do, I will find out the addition of the frequencies for the first key and the second key. That is 5 plus 3 is nothing but 8. This weight I am going to use for the getting cost for 0 comma 2. For the root, first key is root, I will find out the cost 1, 0 comma 2, and if the second key is root, I will find out the cost 2, 0 comma 2. For cost 1, 0 comma 2, what I will do, my formula is C1 I comma minus 1 plus C2 M comma J plus weight. What is my I? I is nothing but my 0, J is nothing but 2, and M is nothing but my key number 1 as a root node, and M minus 1 is nothing but 1 minus 1 is 0. So that's why all these values I will put from this cost matrix, that is C1, 0, 0 is nothing but 0, C2, 1, 2, this is 1, 2, the value is 3, I will put over here, and weight I have already calculated is nothing but 8. So the cost of 1, 0, 2 is nothing but 11. If my root is 13, from this combination of two keys, if my root is 13, in this case, what I'll do, C1 of I, comma M minus 1 plus C2 of M, comma J, this will be C1 of I is nothing but 0 because my I is 0. J, C2 of J is nothing but 2 because my J is 2. My M is nothing but my key number 2 as a root node, so that's why C2 of M is going to become 2, and C1 of M minus 1, that is 2 minus 1 is 1. Now I'll put the cost from my cost matrix, this wala matrix. So 0, 1 is nothing but value 5 that I'm going to put over here. 2, 2 is 0 and my weight is 8 already calculated over here, so the cost is 13. From which, what I need to do, I need to find out the minimum one from the cost 1, 0, 2 and cost 2, 0, 2. So the cost 1, 0, 2 is 11, cost 2, 0, 2 is 13. From this, the minimum one is cost 1, 0, 2. That's why I am going to select this cost 11 to put at the position 0, 2 in my cost matrix. Now let's go forward. Now let's go forward for the next combination of two nodes. For the next combination of two nodes, what I'll do, I'll find out the cost for J is equal to 3 and I is equal to 1. Because 3 minus 1 is nothing but 2, and here I am applying the combination of two nodes. So what I'll do, I'll find out the cost of 1, 3. I'll find out the cost of 1, 3. So here what I'll do, either 13 is going to become root node or 16 is going to become a root node, because next two keys now I'm going to consider. Next two keys are 13 and 16. How I'm going to decide? That I'll decide from J. J is equal to 3, it means that the third key I am going to consider along with the its previous key, that is 2. So that's why 13 and 16 I am going to consider. So either 13 is going to become a root node or a 16 is going to become a root node. So I'll find out the weight by performing addition of the frequencies of second and third key. 3 plus 6 is nothing but 9. So here now let's find out the cost 1. 1, 3 and cost 2, 1, 3. Here cost 1 is for the root node 13, cost 2 is for root node 16. By applying a formula again, C1 of I, comma M minus 1 plus C2 of M, comma J plus weight. I and J are 1, 3, so that's why C1 of I and C2 of J is nothing but 3. M is nothing but 2, key number 2 is going to become a root node, so that's why C2 of M is 2 and C1 of M minus 1, that is 2 minus 1 is 1. I'll put these values from my cost matrix, that is C1, C1 1, 1 is 0, C2 2, 3 is 6, here you can see that 2, 3 is 6 and weight is 9. So total cost of 1, 1, 3 is 15. In the same way, I'll apply for the root number, key number 3. So that's my M is 3 and M minus 1 is 2. The I and J are 1, 3. So by putting the values from my cost matrix, this wala cost matrix, my cost of 2, 1, 3 is nothing but 12. From these, I need to find out the minimum one, either from the cost of 1, 1, 3, or cost of 2, 1, comma 3. From these two, I'll find out the minimum one is nothing but the cost is nothing but 12, which is the minimum one. So at the position 1, comma 3 in the given cost matrix, I'll put the value 12 over here. Now I'll go forward for the next one. For the next one, for the combination of two nodes, if my j is equal to 4 and I is equal to 2, I will find out the value for cost of 2 comma 4. 4 is nothing but j, that is nothing but the key number which always comes along with the key number 3. So my next combination of two nodes is nothing but 16 and 28. Third key and fourth key. So for last two keys, I'll find out the combination, or I'll find out the cost from which I'll find out the minimum one, cost 1, 2 comma 4, or cost 2, 2 comma 4. From these two costs, I'll find out the minimum one to put at the position cost of 2 comma 4. Now if two keys are there, again either 16 is going to become a root node or a 28 is going to become a root node. If my 16 is root node, the cost is 10 by applying a formula. You can go through the formula where m is equal to 3, m minus 1 is 2, I comma j is 2 comma 4. So accordingly, just put the values from this cost matrix. Currently the weight for by performing addition of the frequencies of third and fourth key, 6 plus 2 is 8, and accordingly the cost of 1, 2 comma 4 is nothing but 10, and cost 2, 2 comma 4 is 14, again by putting the values from the given cost matrix. So in this way, the minimum one is, if my root is 16, the cost is minimum, that is 10, and I'll put that to the position 2 comma 4 in my cost matrix. So the first 0 comma 2 is 10, 1 comma 3 is 12, and 2 comma 4 is 10, as far as the formula is concerned. In the next slide, I am going to put all these values in my cost matrix. This one is my previous cost matrix, and now after combination of two nodes, after performing the step 2, for all n is equal to j minus I is equal to 2, I'll find out the cost I comma j, and for this my the first combination of j minus I is nothing but 2 minus I is, that is 2 minus 0 is 2, so I'll find out cost of 0 comma 2 is 11 from my previous formula, from my previous slide. For the next combination, I is 1, j is 3, 3 comma 3 minus 1 is 2, cost of 1 comma 3 is 12, and here the root node was 16. And for the last combination, 4 minus 2 is 2, cost of 2 comma 4 was 10 from my previous slide. I'll put these three values in my cost matrix, that is for 0 comma 2 is 11. Here you can see that 0 comma 2 is 11, 1 comma 3 is 12, so here 1 comma 3 is 12, and 2 comma 4 is 10, so 2 comma 4 is 10. Now your question must be like, what is there in this curly bracket? Curly bracket is going to represent to get this minimum cost, which one is my root key. This is nothing but key number. So to get the first as the 11 as the minimum cost, my root was first key, that is 12. To get this 12 as the minimum cost, the root key was 3, the root was 16, and to get the 10 as a minimum cost, root key was 3, or the root was 16, because the combination of two nodes are there. We had gone through in the previous slide that if the 12 and 13 first combination is there, the first, if the 12 is root node, what will be the cost? If 13 is a root node, what will be the cost? The same from which I am going to find out the minimum one. So the if the root is 12, the cost is minimum. That's why I am going to select 11 for here. For the next two combination, for 13 as a root node and a 16 as a root node, if the 16 as a root node, the cost was minimum, which one is 12, and I am going to write down the same thing over here. and the next combination was 16 and 28. For 16 as a root node, the cost is 16, which is the minimum than that of the 20 as a root node. So that's why I'm going to select that as the cost of 2, 4. So in this way, I'm going to put all these values in this pink colored cell, updated values, and now I'll go forward for the step number 3. In the step number 3, I'll apply the formula for the combination of 3 nodes. So for the combination of 3 nodes, two possibilities are there. Either the first combination of 3 nodes is nothing but 12, 13 and 16, and the second combination is nothing but 13, 16 and 28. So now let's see what was my previous cost matrix. The same matrix I'll use over here while applying a formula. If my first combination is j is equal to 3, that is for the key number 3, it will come along with the key number 2 and 1, previous two keys, because this is the combination of 3 nodes. For the combination of 3 nodes, for 12, 13 and 16, here you can see that the first 3 keys 12, 13 and 16, I need to consider if my root is 12, what will be my cost? If my root is 13, what will be my cost? And if my root is 16, what will be my cost? So please, you can see that to find out the cost 0, 3, I need to find out the minimum from the cost 1, 0, 3, or the cost 2, 0, 3, or the cost 3, 0, 3. From these three different costs, that is this cost as cost 1, 0, 3, cost 2, 0, 3, and cost 3, 0, 3, from these three costs, I'll find out only the minimum one. To apply the formula, I need to find out first of all the weight 0, 3. That is the addition of frequency, that is 5 plus 3 plus 6 is nothing but 14, and I'll use this weight in the formula. So if my root is 12, that is key number 1, so my C2 of m is going to become 1 and C1 of m minus 1 is 0. Accordingly, I'll apply C1 of I and C2 of j is nothing but I is 0 and j is 3. And accordingly, I'll apply the values, I'll put the values from my cost table, and my first cost 1, 0, 3 is nothing but 26. In the same way, if my root is 13, that is key number 2, m is nothing but 2, and accordingly, if I'll apply the values from my cost matrix, cost 2, 0, 3 is 25, and if my root is 16, that is key number 3, the cost is nothing but 25, from which the minimum one is this 25. Why I'm going to select this 25? Because these both the values are same. Yes, because now this 16, the number 16 or a key number, key 16, key number 3 will be having the highest frequency, and for the highest frequency, our assumption is the if the highest frequency number is there, that we need to put at the higher level, that is at the root level. So that's why I'm going to use this key number 3 as a root node if I am having the same cost in the same level or same step. Now let's go forward for the next combination. If my j is equal to 4 and I is equal to 1. For j is equal to 4 and I is equal to 1, for all these combination, I will find out the cost 1, 4. For this, I will consider j is equal to 4, means 4. Key number 4 will come along with its previous two keys, that this nothing but key number 2 and 3. From the key number 2, 3 and 4, I'll consider 13, 16 and 28. From which I'll find out if my 13 is a root node, what is my cost? If 16 is a root node, what is my cost? And if 28 is my root node, what is my cost? For this, what I'll do, cost of 1, 4, for which I'll find out the minimum one, the cost 1 of 1, 4, or cost 2 of 1, 4, or cost 3 of 1, 4, from which I'll find out the minimum one. Now before going to the formula, I need to find out the weight 1, 4 by performing the addition of the frequencies, 3 plus 6 plus 2 is nothing but 11. If my root is 13, that is key number 2 is my root node, my cost is 21 by applying a formula. If my root is 16, then my cost will be 16 by applying a formula again. And if my root is 28, that is key number 4, by applying a formula, I am having a cost is 23. From which I need to select the minimum one, which I am going to select 16 as the minimum cost if my root node is key number 3. So what I will do now for the cost matrix for these two values, that is 0,3 and 1,4. For the cost of 0,3, the minimum cost is 25. I am going to select for the root key number is 3, and for this one, for 1,4, the cost is 1,4. I will select the minimum cost as 61 if my root key is key number 3 again. I will put both these values in my proposed cost matrix in the next slide. So in this next slide, for the combination of 3 nodes, for n is equal to j minus I is equal to 3, first combination is for j is equal to 3 and I is equal to 0, cost of 0,3 is 25, where the root node was 33 and its key number was 3, and it must be 28. Both must be 28. By mistake I have kept or written as it is 33. And the next combination of j minus I is nothing but 4 minus 1 is 3. So cost of 1,4 is 16 as far as the previous slide is concerned. The root node is 28 and its key number position is 3. I am putting all these values in my cost matrix, that is 25 and 16. For both the root node was key number 3. And for now, the next single value I need to calculate in my next slide for the combination of 4 nodes. For the combination of 4 nodes, I am going to find out the value for 0,4. For the 0,4, that is j is equal to 4, I is equal to 0, I need to find out the cost of 0,4, from which the 4 combinations are there. Because I am going to use 4 different keys. J is equal to 4 and the combination of 4 nodes, that's why it will come along with the previous 3 keys. For the previous 3 keys, that is key number 3, key number 2 and key number 1. For these keys, I will find out the minimum from the cost 1, 0,4, or cost 2, 0,4, or cost 3, 0,4 and cost 4, 0,4, from which the minimum one I am going to select as the final cost of 0,4. For all the keys 12, 13, 16 and 28, weight is the addition of frequency of all the keys, that is 5 plus 3 plus 6 plus 2 is nothing but 16. If 4 keys are there, either 12 can be a root node, or 13 can be a root node, or 16 can be a root node, or 28 can be a root node. By applying a formula again, now I think there is no any need to explain these values, how I have put it, I have used these values for I, m minus 1, m, j and all for all the 4 combinations. It's I think not needed. If you want to explain its explanation again, you can go to the step 2. You can see, and again let's check whether these values are correct or not. For the cost 1, 0,4 is 32 by putting the values from this cost matrix. Cost 2, 0,4 is 31. Cost 3, 0,4 is 29. If my root is key number 3. And the cost 4, 0,4 is 36 if my root is 28. So for all these values, I am going to select the minimum one, that is 29. Now let's go forward for the insertion of all these values for the 4 nodes. For 4 nodes, a single combination is there, that is 4 roots can be possible, from which I am going to select the single one. So cost of 0,4 is nothing but 29 for the root number 28. Here it must be again 28, that is key number 3. I'll put all these values in my cost matrix, that is 29 if my root node is key number 3. You can see over here where I have put all these values in the curly bracket, it indicates that this is nothing but my root key. If my root key is 3, then I am getting the optimal cost, the minimum cost for the combination of 4 nodes. Now let's go forward. From this cost matrix, how to construct the optimal binary search tree. So for the construction of optimal binary search tree, I'll use this cost matrix. From this cost matrix, what I am getting now, this is nothing but my the minimum cost of my optimal binary search tree is nothing but 29. For this 29, my root node is 3. So if my root node is 3, this is nothing but a key number, not the key value. If key number 3 is going to become a root node, as I explained previously, my frequency table will be having all the keys in increasing order. So that's why if my key number 3 is my root node, all its previous keys, that is key number 1 and 2, are going to part of a left subtree of optimal binary search tree, and the keys which are next to key number 3 are going to become a part of a right subtree. So for this, what I'll do, for its left subtree I'll write down 0,2, and for the right subtree I'll start with the root itself, that is 3,4. Now in the next step, what I'll do, for this 0,2, I'll go in this matrix 0,2. This value is nothing but 11. For this subtree, the optimal cost is nothing but 11 if root node is 1, which I have already mentioned over here in my cost matrix. So what I'll do, I'll replace it with the root key number, that is 1. If the 1 is key number, then its previous key is going to become, all the previous keys is going to become as a left subtree, and all its right subtree keys are nothing but next to the key number 1, but before the 3, because less than 3 is the property of my binary search tree. So what I'll do, I'll do the next thing, that is I'll find out which key number is there at this position. So now for 1,3, you can see that for 1,3, the number is nothing but the value is present, that is nothing but 12. But for this value, it should be the key number 2. 1,2. This is 1 and this one is 2. Sorry, previously I was going for this 1,3. No, this is nothing but 1,2. So this 1,2 is nothing but 3. 3 is a frequency of which node? 3 is a frequency of node 2 or key number 2. So that's why I'll put this 1,2, I'll replace it with the key number 2. So for this key number 2, I'll put this as a 2 as my key, and this right child of this node 1, and this 2 is divided into its left subtree as 1,1 and its right subtree is 2,2. And the last one, for this 3,4, what I'll do, I'll go for the next one, that is 3,4. What is 3,4? 3,4 is nothing but frequency again 2, of which node or the key number 4. So that's why this 3,4 I'll replace with 4. Its left child is 3,3 and its right child is 4,4. So in this way I have done with the construction of optimal binary search tree. In the next slide, I'm going to convert this optimal binary search tree with the help of keys which are present in my frequency table. So my frequency table is with me, and now this is my matrix, cost matrix. This is the tree generated, optimal binary search tree generated by us in the previous slide, and now this is my final result of optimal binary search tree. The key 3 is I am going to replace with the key 16. Key 1 I am going to replace with its key 12. Key number 4 I am going to replace it with the key value 28, and key number 2 I am going to replace it with the key value 13. By applying the frequencies at every level, you will come to know that 16 is having frequency 6 at the level 1, that's why 6 multiplied by 1 is 6. 12 is having frequency 5, which is at the level 2, that's why 5 2s are 10. 28 is also at level 2 with the frequency 2, that's why 2 2s are 4. And last 13 is at level 3 with the frequency 3, that is 3 3s are 9. By performing addition of all these costs, the total cost of my optimal binary search tree is 29, is equal to whatever I have calculated previously with the help of formula. So in this way, you can construct the optimal binary search tree with the help of cost matrix. Thank you, dear friends. Before that, okay, I need to give some key points to remember. Keys must be in increasing order in the frequencies. The next key point to remember is that I need to find out every time the cost of I, j, where j is always a key number. Now, after that, I need to find out the minimum one from the combination of different keys, that is in step 0 for the 0 number of keys, in step 1 single number of key, in step 2 from the 2 number of keys, I need to find out the minimum one for every key as a root node. For the combination of 3, again from the combination of 3 roots, I need to find out the minimum one. For the combination of 4 nodes, I need to find out the minimum one. So in every step, I need to find out the minimum one, and that I need to put into the cost matrix. And the last thing that we will do with the help of this formula, that is cost of I, j is equal to minimum of cost 1 I, j, cost 2 I, j, cost 3 I, j, according to the number of nodes of the combination, for the all the combination of I, j. And at the end, we need to keep in mind always, for more frequency node, it should be at the higher level, and if the lower frequency node is there, that we need to put at the lowest level in the optimal binary search tree. So thank you, dear friends, for listening my video, watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comments. If you like the content of my video, please like my video, subscribe my channel Tech Talks, share it with your friends, and do not forget to keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification about my channel. Here I am providing some extra link for your reference. You can go through that, and all the best for your future. Thank you.